Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Dr. Sona Ahuja, Associate Professor. We will talk about dimensions of mathematics learning assessment. In this topic, we will try to understand what are the concepts and procedures of mathematics learning, why mathematical reasoning is one of the dimensions of assessment of mathematics learning, and communication and disposition towards mathematics as dimensions of assessment of mathematics learning. So let's first try to see what are the concepts and procedures that ought to be covered for assessment of mathematical learning. Learners, at early stage of learning in maths, the concepts and procedures as prescribed by NCERT 2009 are classified into 10 broad areas. Number, real number system. Number, operations, that is the four fundamental operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Fractions, including decimals. Space and spatial thinking. Measurement. Problem solving. Patterns. Data handling, basic algebraic processes, and simple equations. So while assessing mathematics learning, all the 10 broad areas are to be covered at elementary stage of learning. The next dimensions are learning objectives, that is, all the learning objectives as given by Bloom's in his taxonomy, ranging from knowledge to application and evaluation, are to be covered in assessment of mathematical learning. Then, while preparing the blueprint, that is the plan for assessment, the one of the important dimensions is learning objectives that we have covered right now. And the second dimension of this blueprint is the assessment tools. So we have to use variety of tools to assess the learner, like oral tests, written tests, performance-based test, and we have to cover the entire content prescribed for that level. Thus, the assessment of mathematical learning is basically three-dimensional. So we have to keep in mind three dimensions: learning objectives, assessment tools, and content. And all the three are interrelated. As the content, so would be the learning objectives, and depending on the learning objectives, we will determine the assessment tools. For example, learning objective is defined, then we may have oral test or written test, but when it is construct, then student has to perform, so it has to be activity based. So all the three dimensions of assessment of mathematics learning are interrelated, and these form the basis of the blueprint of any assessment or the plan of any assessment. Apart from these dimensions, there are other dimensions that we should keep in mind, and those are, one of them is mathematical reasoning. While preparing assessment, we have to ensure that we assess the inductive and deductive reasoning of the learner. What do we mean by inductive reasoning? So, when we give one example, similar second example, third example in such situation, and more, and after giving these examples, if student is able to generalize the situation, the formula, the rule, or the principle, then it is said to have inductive reasoning. Thus, the learner uses his inductive reasoning to formulate a rule or generalization or a principle from the given set of examples. And the deductive reasoning is, once he knows the rule or generalization or formula, then is he able to apply this in different situations? Then, if he is able to apply the formula in different situations, he is said to have deductive reasoning. So, in mathematical reasoning, inductive and deductive reasoning are the important dimensions of assessment. Then, how does the learner solve the problems? How does he approach a problem? How does he write the steps of the problem is also to be assessed. Then, how does he present the solutions of the mathematical problem? Here we will assess that, does he present the solutions logically? Is the first step related to the second step and that leads to the third step? For example, while solving the theorems or while proving the theorems, is student writing the logic behind each statement he is giving while proving the theorem? So, in an attempt to prove the theorem, a set of statements are given. But at times, students are not able to find out why this statement is true. So, he has to give logic for that statement. Thus, when learner is able to write down each statement with its logic, then he is said to present the solution logically of the mathematical problems. So, this should also be assessed in the mathematics learning. Now, in the second dimension, we talked about assessment tools. So, which different tools of assessment should be used for mathematics learning? One is oral test, which is very important at elementary level because students like to perform mental math and it improves their memory and intellect. It sharpens their intellect. So, oral tests should definitely be taken and it should be the beginning point of the assessment. So, oral tests you need not take only at the end of the unit, but in classroom also, when you are asking questions to the student, it is kind of oral assessment you are making. Then is the written assessment, that is to see whether student is able to represent the solution of the problem in the written form. Then is the performance, that is you can give them the situation or like you can take them to mathematics laboratory and see if student is able to perform activities related to mathematics. The concepts that you have taught, is he able to actually transfer to the real life kind of situation? So, you can give them models and see if they are able to handle the models, 3D shapes and other things. And the last one and the most important is the observation. So, by observing all the activities, his behavior, his attitude related to mathematics, you can assess student. So, thus these are the tools of assessment of mathematics learning. Now, apart from mathematics reasoning, we should also assess the disposition of learner towards mathematics. Why this is important to assess the disposition of learner towards the mathematics? So that we can catch the learner at the right time. If learner fears the mathematics and a kind of mathematics phobia develops in him, and after a particular stage when it is irreparable, you catch them, then it is difficult to make the repairs. So, you should monitor them regularly through their perception, interest, attitude and personality characteristics for mathematics so that you can catch them at the right time. For example, students do not do mathematics homework regularly. Regularly, he comes up with his answers, answer sheet or notebooks wherein his assignment is not done. So, you need to find out whether he is losing interest in mathematics, then what are the causes of the loss in the interest in mathematics. Does he have negative attitude towards the mathematics, that it is I can't do mathematics, or is he developing some kind of phobia or fear? How does he perceive this subject? So, we need to assess continuously his disposition towards the mathematics. So, the right time remediation can be given to the learner. And the next and the important point is that not only the concepts we should assess of the students in isolation, but we should assess whether students are able to apply the concepts in the day-to-day life. So, this is one of the important dimensions when we talk about the objectives of learning, learning objectives, the first dimension of assessment of mathematics learning we had talked about. So, in this dimension, not only the knowledge, understanding and comprehension, but also the higher order objectives like application should be assessed. We should also assess the use of the symbols, figures, graphs and charts in the written communication. Does these symbols like addition, subtraction, division, equations, mathematical expressions, identities make sense to him? Is he able to differentiate between these symbols, the diagrams, the graphs that he's trying to represent, the figures of the triangles and quadrilaterals he's drawing, how good he is at constructing these figures? So this need to be tested in the written communication apart from just solving the problems. Is he able to communicate mathematics learning? I had seen a situation when I told student to write down an equation and he had written that x plus y. He not only knew that x plus y is not an equation, but he thought that teacher is telling me wrong thing. So it is important that you should tell them how to communicate mathematics. X plus y is equal to 2 when a mathematical expression is equated to another mathematical equation, then it forms an equation. So students should be able to communicate mathematics learning precisely, logically, in the relevant context and in the disciplined form. Because maths is a subject which is precise and concise, and it has very fixed way of expressing itself. We cannot elaborate it like other subjects. If there is an equation, if there is an expression, then it is precise. And if one expression follows another expression or equation follows another equation, then there is logic behind it. And students should be able to communicate the logic behind it. So while assessing mathematics learning, we should keep in mind that student is able to apply mathematics in day-to-day life, use symbols and figures, graphs and charts in written communication, and communicate mathematics learning precisely, logically. Now, while talking about the modes of assessment, how can you assess mathematics learning? It can be formal and informal. Formal is when you take their written or oral tests, and informal is through observation or classroom interaction. Then the types are oral, written and performance. This we have already discussed. And the outcomes can be quantitative and qualitative. In fact, outcome if is only quantitative, then it does not make sense to the learner. If we just give him the score, then it is just another number. It should be qualitative in the sense that the score should tell him the status of his performance. Thus, outcome has to be descriptive, qualitative also. Administration, it can be group or individual. You can take group assessment like we take written tests, those are group. We can take individual oral tests or performance tests, and there the administration is individual. So administration can be either group or individual. Now, assessment has not to be done only through scholastic activities, but also through co-scholastic or co-curricular activities. Let's see which are the dimensions of co-scholastic activities that lead to assessment of mathematics learning. So one is quizzes. You can involve them in quizzes that interest them also. Debates on mathematics, its applications, Olympiad, wherein they perform, and this feeling of satisfaction is there when they are able to actually perform in Olympiad. And even if they are not able to perform, but the preparation itself makes them learn more than what they would do in the usual classroom. Then modeling, there can be exhibitions where they can model, they can prepare the models of the mathematics and model the concepts they have learned in mathematics. Then in exhibitions, these models can be displayed and they can discuss with the audience the concepts that they have displayed through models in the exhibitions, and they can also prepare teaching learning materials. Like we had discussed, for teaching triangles, for teaching 3D shapes, so 2D, two-dimensional or three-dimensional, we can make them prepare the three-dimensional models also, or teaching learning materials. Then an important aspect of assessment of mathematics learning is to assess their creative abilities. Now, how can we assess the creative ability of the learner? It is when they frame unusual but important questions that shows their creativity, and when they solve the problem in novel ways. For example, a Pythagorean theorem can be proved in more than 100 ways. So if student comes up with the novel way to prove a theorem, like we say that when we reach from destination A to destination B, then there is not only one way, but there can be n number of ways to reach from destination A to destination B. So is in mathematics, there can be n number of ways to solve the problem. So is the student able to use his creativity to solve the problem in different ways, in the ways that you taught in the classroom, not only those, but other ways also? Then developing innovative learning materials which can be used for learning, and writing interesting articles or materials on mathematics that speak about the application of mathematics in day-to-day life, drawing unique graphs and diagrams of the mathematical concepts that explain or throw more light on the concepts, creating materials for fun in mathematics like mathematical games or mathematical puzzles. So this is how you can assess the creative ability of learners in mathematics. Then there can be recreational activities where students can enjoy learning, otherwise which they think that mathematics is a dry subject. So you can organize recreational activities, and through these activities you can assess their mathematics learning, like mathematical puzzles, games, different designs wherein they use mathematical concepts. Then through their socio-personal qualities. It is said that mathematics learner is very exact when he speaks. So this reflects the transfer of the concept learning in their socio-personal behavior. So that also assesses his learning, whether the learning has actually transferred into his behavior, his precise expression, his logical approach to all activities, which is the core of mathematics, and the higher order thinking. That is the application and the evaluation and the decision making even. So learners, let's see if you are able to answer these questions. Why mathematical reasoning you think is an important dimension of assessment of mathematics learning? How can you assess the day-to-day life implication of mathematics learning of the students? Explain with examples. How can you assess mathematics learning through co-scholastic activities? So if you are able to answer these questions, you will be able to assess yourself how much you have learned or learned the assessment of mathematics learning, like the dimensions that we learned, the three important dimensions, throw more light on the three important dimensions like learning objectives, which different tools can be used to assess mathematics learning, and what should be the coverage of the content while preparing the test. What should be the frequency, which is again one of the assessment as we talked about it. And then which are the different abilities that ought to be assessed while trying to know how much learner has learnt mathematics, that is creative ability, disposition towards mathematics. So you can give examples, and you must be going for internship. So in internship, you can experience these things. You can just observe mathematics learners, and you can find out that what are the things through which you can observe them and make out whether they are interested in mathematics. So one observation is one of the important dimensions. So share your experiences, how they have learned the mathematics. Thank you.